Well, just explain what's going on here today and then tell us about the gunpowder mills, please.
Essentially, what we're doing here today is we've been helping Guildford Borough Council, who own the site. It's a scheduled monument site, so it's of great importance historically. And we've been helping removing damaging vegetation from the archaeological remains, and also the public are better able to see and understand the site for what it is. It spans some 300 years of working history, using a very good water supply from the Tillingbourne, one of the early industrial rivers in the country, although you wouldn't know that now, as nature is very good at taking over.
Yes.
And it's a hidden gem owned by the borough, and our interest from a volunteer group, Chilworth Gunpowder Mills Group, and in the local community, is to keep this well presented, well managed, for the benefit of all now and in the future.
Right, and as a dad of a nine-year-old, I can't wait to bring my daughter here and let her explore. There's a massive array of wildlife, flora, fauna. I mean, he's got it all here, hasn't he?
Yes, one of the important things that we focus on is taking a holistic attitude to the whole place.
Right.
So it's not just about gunpowder mills and history, it's also for that richness.
Yes.
To be enjoyed by people of all ages.
Yeah.
I brought my children here when they were very young, something like 30 odd years ago. Now my grandchildren come here, and constantly we have hundreds of visitors through the site every week. A lot of them are family groups who stop and picnic and just soak up the, you know, the whole spirit of the place and enjoy its wealth.
The heritage, the nature, like I say, has it all. And the group have even installed some picnic tables, because you really do want to encourage people here, don't you?
Yes, well, we've had one area which we've identified and cleared with a number of picnic benches, and those have proved to be very popular with family groups and also walkers coming through the site,
right,
who make a point of stopping and using it as a pause point, walking along the North Downs Way or just exploring the locality.
Right, and you could easily spend a morning, an afternoon exploring the site, because it is quite a large site, isn't it?
Well, that's one of the joys.
Yeah.
You can touch the site lightly and just follow the main trail and pick up a certain amount of information and just pause at odd points. Or you could indeed spend days here exploring it, which gives great opportunity for repeat visits. So you don't have to do it all at once.
Yeah.
You can pick at it from time to time, and you'll always be finding something new.
Right, and you organise some organised guided walks here, don't you?
Occasionally, members of the Gunpowder Mills Group are asked to talk about the site or to help with guided walks. We have a walk coming up from the CBA Southeast,
right,
where historians and archaeologists will come round and sort of look at the site and get a general appreciation of it. As I say, it's a hidden gem. There's an awful lot of history and archaeology in Surrey. We're never short of material.
Right, and is there anywhere there where people can find out more about it? I mean, do you have a web presence or anything like that?
The Tillingbourne Tales and Trails Project,
yeah,
does have a website in which,
yes,
the history is going to be conveyed.
Yes.
Together with a lot of other useful information about other industries up and down the Tillingbourne Valley.
Yes.
Which was, in history, very intensively used.
Yes.
And now there are only shadows and suggestions of what was there. But yes, that is in development.
But there was a massive industry in the Tillingbourne Valley, wasn't there? I mean, it wasn't just gunpowder mills,
oh,
there was
news.
Paper mills, there was all sorts here, wasn't there?
Wire making,
yeah.
Pulling. There will be a blacksmithy using a water wheel somewhere at some point, although we haven't identified where. Paper mills, as you say, gunpowder production, flour production, it's all basically here. The earliest mill actually for Chilworth is at Doomsday.
Right.
So it's a very long history here.
Yeah.
Chilworth is, as a little hamlet, a considerably venerable area, although you wouldn't know it from the current house.
Thanks so much for taking part in this. Fascinating. I can't wait to really explore this place. Hopefully you'll join me and I can tap into some of your expertise on what I'm looking at.
Certainly, and more people who come and appreciate this and relax here, the better. They won't be disappointed, will they see?
Lovely. Thank you very much.